A month ago, we met an 11-year-old boy who was abandoned by all his parents and then went through hell of a life. He spent a lot of days and nights sleeping under bridges, hence feeding on leftovers. Life was difficult. He was luckily adopted by a mother who also had other children. Though this mother does not have a lot, she has what the boy lacked, a golden parental heart. The woman welcomed the boy and made him feel loved for the boy's very first time. Samuel said his homeless and hopeless life began one day, when him and his twin woke up and realized the mother and the stepfather had gone, leaving them with nothing. A few days later, the landlord chased them away from the house, and they started wandering without knowing where they were even going.
Umunsi umwe ariko wa gatatu turabyuka tugiye kuranyene ko bahari dusanga n'abahari hari n'imyenda yacu dufata icyemezo cyo kuzagenda uko nyine n'iyo manga yanyu.
When we met, he said he only has one wish, and that is to see his parents. Here, he made it clear that even when his parents might not want to live with him again, he just misses the family and would like to see them once again.
Nakicyo bamfasha nuko wenda abanzi wenda mu muryango wanjye nuko za wenda bakanyenda bakanyereka umuryango wanjye aba barabonye papa wanjye cyangwa mama wanjye bajya kumwe wenda banamuzana bakamunyereka.
Diane is the woman who adopted Samuel. She says she saw the boy selling some donuts and followed him up, only to find the little boy was homeless and had been abandoned by his own parents. And that is how she welcomed the boy into her family.
Namubonye ari umwana ugenda ku muhanda afite akadobo arimo acuruza amandazi.
When we aired that story a month ago, a lot of people were touched. They could not hold their tears back. Some of those who watched this felt empathy for the young boy, and many thanked Diane for her loving and courageous act of taking care of this 11-year-old. And today, we're back to this family, but this time, we're not alone. We're accompanied by a lot of good Samaritans who saw what Samuel went through, and they could not delay but come to see this little boy who stole their hearts. It was quite a long journey from the city to this village. But as they say, every journey has an end. And finally, we made it to this beautiful village. Having seen how the situation to Samuel and his life is, these people did not come empty-handed. They came with a lot. I mean, a lot of things, including the cooking gas, the stove, jerrycans of cooking oil, sacks of rice and posho, milk, soaps, mattress, and etc. It's always nice to see beautiful people in and out, reaching out to those people facing different life hardships, with just one intention, blessing their lives. Kindness is one of the greatest gifts you can bestow upon another. If someone is in need, lend them a helping hand. Do not wait for a thank you. True kindness lies in the act of giving without the expectation of something in return. Reaching to this mother's house, it was a joy to watch as they saw Samuel and happily greeted the boy. They all felt happy, as their faces could tell, having made he who made them come here. We talk to this mother and she starts by thanking Afrimax and says this little boy has been a blessing to her. She says the moment Afrimax uploaded their story, people started calling and caring to them. And some people sent a certain amount of money. She thanks all those who keep supporting her.
Mbere ya byose nkaba nshimira Afrimax kuko ntago byari byoroshye gufata Samuel mu bihe byashize wahari agahinda hagati yanjye nawe nibaza uko bizagenda ariko Samuel yambere w'umugisha Afrimax ikimara gushyiraho inkuru ya Samuel abantu benshi bajya bampamagara.
She is so surprised that she wasn't expecting this return. And it's not only returning, but returning with a load of what they needed. This has touched the mama's heart and says she has no words to express her gratitude. All she says is, God bless you.
Byagahebujeho ndishimye cyane ndanezerewe mbonye ko hari abantu bari kumwe nanjye muri iki gikorwa ntago kiba cyoroshye kuko abantu muri iyi minsi basa n'abatakaje umuntu.
What surprised the mother most was the mattress. She says a few days ago Samuel slept on an old mattress and told the mama that sleeping on such a mattress is a big problem, but this mama had no way and no money so as to get him a brand new one. And to her, this surprise is out of this world. She's surprised that these good Samaritans included the mattress.
Tanone ikintu kinunguye ndabonamo matera je wandi Samuel ari kumbwata ka matera karanja kugitanda.
To her, this has restored hope and has made her realize that humanity still exists. She could not ask anything for them rather than blessings from the above.
Ndumiwe n'ukuri gusa Imana ibaho umugisha itagabanyijeho namba ibi bintu nibwo mbibonye nibwo mbonye ko isi gifite abantu bafite ubumuntu nanjye nezerejwe n'aba bavandimwe nezerejwe n'iki gikorwa nezerejwe n'abantu bambaye hafi bamfashe mu mugongo bakajya bankomeza.
She says she can say that ever since Samuel came to their family, the boy has somewhat improved mentally. Before, the boy always had agony and never felt free with them, but now they have built some kind of confidence in him. Diane is sure that Samuel will become a great man in the coming future. She sees a lot of potential in the boy.
Mfite ibyiringiro biri hejuru ko Samuel azakura akaba umugabo kuko nicyo nasabye Imana narabimwifurije.
Samuel took time and thanked Afrimax and all those who contributed to making him happy. He also appreciates what this mama has done to him so far, as he confirms that he's treated like her own son. This is what parents never gave him. He says Diane loves her so much that she even carries him in the back. Olivier is one of these people that came to visit Samuel. He says they're called AfriZone, a platform that does charity activities to the vulnerable. After seeing the first story, he was touched and shared the story with his partners. They started thinking of what to do with the immediate effect, and in so doing, they cooperated and had to visit the boy with something to help Samuel and this family. Reflecting to the mother's wish to Samuel last time, where she says she wants the boy to go back to school.
Uyu mwana nubwo namufashe mu byukuri ndamukunda kuko nkunda abana banjye kandi nawe arankunda hanifuza ko yakwiga ko mbona yabo umuhanga.
The wish as AfriZone is the same. They want to make sure and help Samuel go back to school. What is interesting about these people's platform is that you can buy or order something for someone via their platform. To make it clear, if you want to buy something for Samuel, go to www.afrizone.com and they'll make sure it's well delivered to Samuel. the whole Afrimax thanks whoever that thinks of helping people going through a load, and whoever that does something to make these people happy. Thank you for always supporting our people. You can keep helping Samuel by contributing on the link found in description and pinned in top comments. There is nothing more satisfying than seeing a smiling face around, and that satisfaction exponentially multiplies when you are the reason behind it. What people see you do may not be remembered, what they hear you say may be forgotten, but how they feel your intervention in their times of need will be forever remembered. Thank you for watching. I'm Elijah, and this is Afrimax English. Remember to subscribe.